I didn't have an easy experience. I didn't have come in as a top-rated recruit. I didn't come in with the opportunity to play right away. I had to earn it. And you know what the greatest honor I've ever received as a player is? In my fourth year, in my fifth year, I was named team captain. That, to this day, is the single greatest achievement I've ever had as a football player. Because the men in this room chose me to lead their team. And these were my best friends. These were the guys that knew that I liked to work, that knew that I loved football, that knew that I loved to play, that knew that I wanted to be the quarterback for Michigan. And all the lessons that I learned here on State Street and in the big house, that's still what I bring to practice today. And after 14 years, I love the game more than I've ever loved it. But where did I learn to love for the game? Where did I learn to practice? Where did I learn to compete? It was sitting in the same chairs that you guys are sitting in today.
We were led to believe that he was going to be drafted, possibly second round, probably third round. They kept calling quarterback names, and we kept being stunned.
You see, you know, so-and-so get picked, and then there's nine more picks gone until one team that you think was interested. You know, you get pretty anxious.
We were very distraught. With each name, it was becoming worse and worse.
So I remember being downstairs for like the fourth round, and that came and gone. And the fifth round was coming and going, and all these other guys were getting picked.
Beginning of the sixth round, he says, I got to get out of here. So he gets up, comes downstairs, and grabs the baseball bat and starts walking up the street.
You know, I don't want to sit around and maybe my hopes get up, or I'd rather just take my mind off it.
And finally, he comes back into the house, and it's about the 22nd pick of the sixth round. And he says, I got to get out of here. The poor guy, the tension in the house is just really rough.
And it was hard. I remember taking a walk with my dad and mom around the block.
I think there's nothing I'd rather do. So I don't have a lot of hobbies, you know. I play golf every once in a while, but there's something in my DNA that loves this game. And right. I never want it to go away. You know, but my goal is to play, you know, because I love the game and I don't really plan on doing anything else. And I want to play, then, you know, what else do I have? It is my job to take care of myself year round. So, you know, to eat the right things, to drink the right things, to, you know, keep my body pliable the way it needs to be, to sustain the hits, to make the throws,
right.
You know, to keep my brain working the right way. I mean, all those things, that's what I think about in February. That's what I think about, you know, in August. That's what I think about in November. So, you know, I just love playing. I don't want it to go away anytime soon. You know, being in a situation where they say, well, you're 37. I'm still thinking 30s. I feel like I'm 27, right. You know, and I just want to keep doing it. So I have a lot of fun. I mean, if you get to play football for a living, I mean, what could be any better than that?
When I'm playing football, I appreciate it. I'm nowhere else. I'm in the present. It's probably the best part about my life is that to be in the present. You talk about how do you enjoy your life? How do you find balance, right? It's to live in the present. You play, to live like a kid. Like, why do kids have so much fun? Because they just care about what they're doing.
Yeah.
And if we thought about what we were doing all the time, you do that when you're on the football field. It's probably the only place that I can really do that, when I really truly am my authentic self. I mean, a lot of people see it, my close friends do, but when I'm on the football field, it's just raw. I would say it's made me a better teammate. It's an evolution as a person, and I think my appreciation for the game is at the highest it's ever been. And I think because the priorities, you know, you have your priorities and you make your priorities. So my family is, you know, one, and then football is 1A, you know, and when it's family time, it's family time. And when it's football time, it's football time. And
well, everyone has their different belief systems. And I think everyone has their different opinions of, you know, those types of things that you talked about. Certainly as an athlete, I care very much what I put into my body. I think that I'm 38 years old. I'm not 22 anymore.
You look good.
You're very sweet. Thanks. But you know, all those things are important, and all the little things add up to be big things. So when I'm trying to accomplish things professionally, that, you know, in a lot of ways, I'm in uncharted territory. So I've got to do things differently, and I got to evolve over time. I've got to, things that may have worked in the past, maybe don't work as you move forward. So the lessons that I've learned through my own trial and error, I think I'm at that point in my career, I'm very efficient with what I'm doing. So
I try to eat healthy. I try to get the right amount of rest. I try to do the right types of exercise so I can be on the field and be available to my team. I try to be, you know, as productive this time in my career as I was earlier.